Okay, hi guys, this is Christian from SwimtoFly.com. Today we're going to learn how to swim freestyle in three simple steps to master the front crawl. So remember that the front crawl is always something easy to learn. The first thing is to remember the intention. So when you swim freestyle, you need to learn how to glide, how to stretch forward, and how to relax, okay? It's all about relax. Swimming is all about sensation, relax, and be effective and effortless with big stroke, powerful underwater, and the right way of movement. So there is three steps to learn how to swim front crawl, which are really easy. We're gonna start now with the first step. Before everything, you need to learn how to kick in the water correctly, and you need how to feel the gliding sensation, the correct posture when you are in the water. So we're gonna start on the shallow side, just to show you how to practice the kicking. Okay, so I'm here in the freestyle kick. Need to be done with your feet like straightened here, your knees like not bent. No, I keep my legs straight, and it's just the kick like this, one after one. Okay, try to avoid to bend your knees and do biking in the water. This is completely ineffective kicking. Okay. So what you want to do is just do small and fast movements with kicking like this. And you kick faster on the surface. You see my feet here on the surface? Kick. And I can see the water on the surface moving. Of course, when you swim freestyle, you are on the other side. So for the freestyle, since we are on the other side, my legs need to be on the surface of the water. Okay, same thing. Don't bend your knees. Kick small and fast. Can you listen behind me? The pum pum, pum 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 pum. This is the sound of my kick kicking the water. So your kicking, remember, need to be on the surface, fast, with the sound behind you. Okay. Once you are able to do your kicking, to master the step number one, which is the arrow position, you need to learn how to put your head and your arms correctly to glide on the surface. So the arrow position is to be able to start, push on the wall, glide with your hand correctly positioned, and kick, 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 and that's it for 5 meters. So if I want to practice the arrow position, I need to go always deeper. Alright, so I'm gonna do the arrow position for like maybe 5 meters only. So I'll put my feet on the wall, I will kick the way I have shown, and I will straighten my hands like this on the surface of the water. Remember that your hand here need to stay on the surface side by side. You can practice like this, straighten your arms, or you can, if you want to learn from a simple way, you can be side by side, straighten your arms. What you want to do is to stretch your arms. Remember, that's the key point. You want to fly, you want to swim freestyle, so you want to glide forward. If your elbow are bent like this, you're not flying, this is broken. The more you stretch forward, the faster and the easiest you're gonna swim, okay? So, step number one, to learn how to swim control, arrow position. I glide. Take my deep breath, 5 second bubbles in the water, kick, 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 kick with my feet and glide forward. And that's it. Okay, pretty easy. I go back on the other side. Remember, when you do your bubbles, try to look straight down at the bottom of the swim. Chin on your chest, your head below your arms. Don't be like this, your head's up. You want to look down, so we cannot see your head all the way. You are in the perfect gliding position. Remember, that position is called arrow position. Show you again. Okay, I keep my kick on the surface, small and fast, don't bend your knees, my head is down, I blow my bubbles, relax 5 seconds, my hand on the surface, don't move. One more time. Alright, so when I can master my arrow position, that is very good. You can now learn how to swim with paddling in the water with your hand. It's time to learn the step number two, which is learn how to do the strokes with your hand. So freestyle is swimming with your hand, gliding, relax, blow your bubbles, and gliding forward. Now, you need to learn how to paddle inside the water with your hand by being able to still glide in the water. A lot of people, they fight in the water, they swim, they spend so much energy to try to swim faster, and they swim so slow, and they are so exhausted after just 10 meters of swimming, because they don't try to feel what is the gliding position. A big stroke with the other hand gliding forward. Every stroke needs to be big, strong in the water, and relaxed outside the water. So to learn how to swim with the step number two, we'll just repeat the step number one. We'll just repeat the arrow position. 1, 2, 3. Kick, 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 blow your bubbles. But this time you will have a little board in your hand. Okay, when you have a board like this, it's a small board. If I push the board down, you're gonna drown, okay? A lot of people, they learn how to swim with board, but they push the board down because the board is huge, the board stays up. But that's not the way, because you never wanna go down. You wanna go forward, you wanna glide, right? So, you do your arrow position 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. With your bubbles, your kick on the surface, this is all good, okay? The step number one is perfect. Okay, all right. So now, you need to learn how to do the same with paddling in the water. One big stroke paddle. Bubbles, 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 bubbles. Two big stroke, bubbles, 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 paddle. And then, at the third stroke, you need to breathe. You're gonna learn how to swim freestyle by taking a big breath every third stroke. Why third and why not two? Because you will learn how to swim both sides, left and right. Later, when you compete, you can do only learn every two stroke, breathe every four strokes, whatever you fits you well. But when you learn both sides, left and right. So you blow bubbles for your 5 seconds, and during your 5 second bubbles, you do one big stroke, go back to the board. Two big stroke, go back to the board. Three big stroke, breathe. Go back to the board, and continue. One big stroke, go back to the board. Two big stroke, blow your bubbles, go back to the board. Three big stroke, breathe. Go back to the board. Okay, at the beginning, if you are a beginner, don't focus so much on turning on the side. Learn the rhythm. 1, 2, breathe at number 3. The rhythmic is very important for the step 2, okay? So, I don't want to learn how to breathe on the side yet. It's a bit too advanced. So I will go very easy with learn how to just move my hand and go up at number 3. I have my board. One big stroke, two big stroke, go up at number 3, go down and continue, okay? This is the arrow position with the board and moving the hands. So let's practice. Same position, head down, big bubbles. Let's go. As you can see, when you go up with your head, you lose a bit balance. When you go up with your head, you start to drown a little bit. This is normal. That's why when you go up, you try to breathe fast, okay? And try to pull and breathe at the beginning. If you are a beginner, it's much easier. Because your hand pulling in the water will give you power to go up and breathe. And then have the time to go down and blow your bubbles. So we repeat the skill again. One bubbles, two stroke bubbles, three stroke go up, breathe, and go down. Be careful when you go up, don't let your legs behind you drown. Keep your legs on the surface, kicking quick and fast, okay? With kicking, doing this little sound on the surface. Blow your bubbles and be relaxed. It's much easier if you turn your head.
Because if you go up, you lose your balance and your lower body starts to drown. You go up, you go down. And that's why every swimmer, when they learn the correct freestyle stroke, they're gonna turn the head to breathe instead of going up and look forward. To turn the head is very easy. You just need to turn at the right time with your half face in the water. The closer you are, the better you are. Don't stress. You need to keep your half face in water when you breathe here and breathe with your mouth here outside the water. Most of people, they believe that if they turn up like this is good, but this is wrong. My head is up, my lower body gonna drown behind me. You don't want to do that. You wanna go down with your head, with your eyes inside the water. Half of your face inside the water, here. And then I go down. Okay, so the stroke is very simple, but remember, when you wanna breathe on the side, half face cut by the water. My eyes inside, my mouth outside, breathe. Blow bubbles go down again. And tricky portion about it. You want to pull and turn at the beginning. Remember, pull and turn in the same time. Don't pull first and turn after, especially when you are a beginner, because it will be more complicated. Okay? So feel the power, turn your head. So I have my board. I do my arrow position, I repeat my stroke, but this time, instead of going up, I'm gonna turn my head. But when I turn my head, I make sure that I turn down in the water with my arms here, never use as a pillow here. Don't put your head on your arms. Put your arms forward and put your head in the little hole here. Ears in the water, arm face in the water, over there, not on your arms. This is the mistake to do, okay? Going up. Go down in the hole here. Here. What? Here. Okay. And remember, you look on the side here. It's pretty easy. Now let's try. Up here. Take my big breath. You have to see something, because I hold that board. When I turn my head, I keep my hand with the board on the surface of the water. I don't want my hand, when I turn my head, to go down. That's the thing. You need to learn how to swim freestyle by keeping your hands on the surface of the water, to glide forward, to fly, okay? So always make sure your hands are on the surface. When you turn your head, don't let your hand go down. This is missing. You see my hand is down, I lose. I keep my hand up. I push myself to glide until the other one is going back, okay? So 1, 2, 3, turn at number 3 with your hands on the surface, catching the board all the time. This board never goes down, okay? Practice the step number 2 last time. Blow my bubbles. I can swim into the arrow position, which is the step 1. I do my strokes underwater, relax, big, catch my board forward. The board stay on the surface. I turn at number 3. I can turn now with half face in the water. Excellent. He start to learn how to swim freestyle at step number 3, so I don't need the board anymore. Okay, now we are at the last step for the freestyle. So to learn freestyle, with the last step, you just need to remember, it's pretty simple. You need to keep your hand forward and on the same things, you need to be able to keep your hand on the surface and imagine you have a magic board with your hand. Okay? Imagine you have a magic board in your hand, so it's the same point. You want to learn how to swim with your hand gliding on the surface but never going down. One stroke, two stroke, keep the magic board on the surface. Three, turn your head, but my hand don't go down. You see my hand here? Don't go down, don't go down, don't go down. Go touch your hand, tack. And again, one stroke, go back. Two stroke, go back. Turn at number three, go back. Okay, for the step number three, you learn how to swim on the first part, the freestyle touch, with your hand staying on the surface of the water. So one big touch, two big touch, three, turn at number three, and touch. Means your hand never goes underwater. Never let your hand drop in the water. Especially when you turn your head, don't drop your hand. Keep it on the surface here, and touch your hand, okay? Can you see my hand here? Yeah? You keep it on the surface, okay? Never forget. Well, let's practice.
You have the magic board, it's the same things. I just don't hold the board. I just imagine it's the board.
Big stroke.
See my hand here?
Stays on the surface. When I turn my hand don't drop. Okay? I do one more time. Freestyle touch. Turn at number three with your hands on the surface. Don't forget your bubbles. And swim into the arrow position looking down. So this is the step number three, freestyle touch. This is not yet the real freestyle. The step number three is having three portions. When you can do that, when you can blow your bubbles, do your big stroke, touch your hand every time, keep your hand on the surface, and touch your skin. Touch my skin, go back, touch my skin, turn, breathe on the side, touch my skin. Then you can practice with the pool boy in between your legs. It will be the step number three, part number two. This is a pool boy. This pool boy will be in between your legs. You close your knees like this, and you close your legs. Because you have these floaties in between your legs, it will be easier for your legs. You're gonna float more. But the problem is you cannot kick anymore. You need to just close your legs. And because you cannot kick, you lose a bit of balance. Because you lose a bit of balance, you're gonna practice more on your upper body to balance your body. So it's a bit more complicated, but it's great for the sensation. So part number two, to learn the freestyle, okay? And the step number three is to do the same skill, freestyle touch, with a board in between your legs. So you turn at number three, but you don't drop your hand, you touch your hand, but you cannot kick this time. Okay, let's practice. So as you see, I turn, one touch, two touch, turn my head on the side, breathe, my hand stay up, and I touch. Make sure your hand always stays up, okay? It's kind of important here. So this is the step number three, part number two, freestyle touch with a board in between your legs. So we are going back, the same skill again, okay? So you can practice and look at the hand. The more difficult portion is to make sure your hand don't drop in the water. When I turn my hand here, and drop in the water. You see my hand here? Hello? You need to follow my hand when I explain my hand, okay? Two, one, let's go. OK. Okay, so this is done. You will see sometimes when you turn your head, because you cannot kick, your body will twist and you can turn your body in the water. That mistakes might happen, so it's you to turn your head at the right time and to practice again to be able to swim straight forward, okay? So let's do it. Now I can do my freestyle touch with a board in between my legs. This is perfect. So let's remove the full buoy. I can kick again. And now I'm gonna learn the real freestyle. So you can do the freestyle touch, one hand after one hand, touching and waiting. This is a great skill to do, but that's not the real freestyle yet. The real front crawl will be with your hands crossing on the surface. No more touch, and touch, and touch, but crossing. When my hand is gliding forward, the other one is coming back, and will not touch, but they will glide, crossing on the surface. And I glide, I cross, and I cross, and I breathe at number three. So one, glide, two, glide, three, glide, turn, and breathe, okay? Step number three, part number three, freestyle glide. You need to learn how to fly when you swim, and you will learn also how to use your elbow to relax. You will learn how to pull in the water with your elbows up. Pull to the end, then at the end, relax. Roll your shoulders, elbows up, glide with the other hand, and when this one is coming back, then change. Pull and glide. And pull, when I pull, the other one is gliding. You see, this is together. One hand is pulling the water, the other one is gliding. It's always like this. A lot of people, they focus on this hand, the pulling one. But that's a little mistake, because the very important portion is actually why this hand is pulling. This hand is pulling to help this one. This one is the more important. This one is the gliding one. The one on the front is the one stretching forward. When you pull to make the other one gliding. Never lose that intention. You wanna glide forward, you wanna grow, you wanna fly, you wanna stretch forward. Okay, that's why we are in the arrow position. So you glide by pulling. I pull and I glide. I pull and I glide. I pull and I glide. At the number three, I turn my head at number three and I glide. I don't go down, I go forward. And again. So freestyle glide. This time you need to touch, just make sure you cross and you glide on the surface. Try a demonstration. Repeat the skill again. One glide, two glide, turn at number three and glide. Okay, remember to keep your elbows up, roll your shoulder and relax. When you can relax, with at number three, be comfortable, increase the distance, increase the intensity, because this is great. Now you can swim your freestyle, catch the right sensation. Remember, swimming is all about sensation. You need to feel it right. You need to feel that you're stretching for a while. You need to feel the glide on your skin. You need to feel it easy. It's not fighting, it's easy. All right? So to learn how to swim freestyle, just three simple steps. Remember, arrow position. Learn to swim the arrow position with the stroke, with a board forward, to learn how to keep your hand on the front. And breathe at number three. And step number three, need to do without the board, to learn how to glide forward. Don't drop your hand in the water. Always make sure your hand stays on the surface to glide and glide and glide. When you feel it, you will see you are not fighting anymore in the water. You're just enjoying the swim. Okay? So this is Christian from swimfly.com. If you want to download our method to swim freestyle, just visit our website. And for swimming lesson, you can check on the website also. Thank you.